being a Christian athlete, I wouldn't trade it for the world. Obviously, it saved my life. I think being on a team like this, there's a lot of believers and guys that have been able to help me along the way. And my faith has led to probably my best year that I've had in the NFL. So I think just having that courage, having those guys encourage me, being able to go out there and kind of preach the word, and anytime we get, I think it's an honor to be able to do that at this in this platform.
I think it takes a lot of courage to be a Christian athlete because people often want to tell you, you know, keep your faith and your politics out of, you know, a lot of sports. And so for me, I'm very open about it. I'm very open about being imperfect. So to be able to play on a platform where people see that, you know, in terms of if you make a mistake on the field, people see that. But I also think it's important that, you know, people don't put you on a pedestal, and they also see, you know, even when you make mistakes in real life, you see people as people.
As far as courage, just, you know, expressing it, being able to, you know, dive deeper into the word, so that way when I do speak about it, I know what I'm talking about, and I'm like reciting scripture, and I'm not just talking about what I think.
It takes a lot of courage. In college, you know, everyone's saying it's not cool to do this, it's not cool to do that, but about my priority is to glorify God each and every day, each and every situation. That's the one thing I've been called to do. If you're able to do that, you're not gonna have any regrets down the road. I think it's courageous if people are, when they're able to go through that college environment and kind of stay strong and maintain that foundation of God and Christ, and it's a powerful thing, and my hat's off to them.
I will go back to Matthew 6:34. Don't worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow has its own worries. Today's troubles are enough for the day. 2 Corinthians 5:7, just so you know, walk by faith, not by sight. Those scriptures helped me throughout my adverse times in my walk.
As a Christian, it should be your responsibility to help others. For us to stay silent on things, you're just as guilty as a person who may be on the other side of, you know, those issues, whether it's oppression or, I mean, the type of love that Christ has shown us. We'd be selfish if we don't share it.